So let me start with some examples that motivate the need for verifying software. The first example I want to use is the famous Ariane 5. And if you remember, that's a rocket that exploded not too long after departure because of a software error. And even without going to such dramatic examples, I'm sure you're all familiar with this kind of situation, or this one, or again this one. And here I'm not really picking on any specific organization, operating system, or software. The point I want to make is that software is buggy. In fact, a federal report from a few years ago assessed that software bugs are costing the US economy $60 billion every year. In addition, studies have shown that software contains, on average, 1 to 5 bugs every 1,000 lines of code. Building 100% correct mass market software is just impossible. And if this is the case, what can we do? What we need to do is to verify software as much as possible. In this part of the course, we will discuss how we can do this. We will discuss different alternative ways of verifying software systems, with particular attention to the most common type of verification, which is software testing. Before doing that, however, let me go over some basic terms that are commonly used, and I have to say often misused, in the context of software verification.